Hello and welcome to People's Dispatch special feature on the Great March of Return protest in Gaza. The 30th of March 2019 was the first anniversary of these protests, one of the most momentous acts of resistance in this decade. For one whole year, tens and thousands of Gazans have been protesting every Friday against Israeli occupation. This is despite barbaric violence by Israeli forces. People's Dispatch brings you exclusive footage from Gaza that examines this violence by Israel, the cost of the prolonged siege of Gaza, and the inspiring fight back mounted by millions of Palestinians. In the latest protests on March 30th, 4 persons were killed and over 205 injured due to Israeli firing. Tamar Abi Al-Khair, Adam Amara, Bilal Al-Najjar, all of whom were just 17 years old, were killed in Israeli gunfire. 20-year-old Mohammed Jihad Saad was killed the night before in another demonstration. This is not new for the people of Gaza. However, this has not dented their spirit, and they continue to march to the borders in large numbers. We spoke to Arij Al-Ashkar, a member of the Great March of Return Committee of Women, on popular participation in the protests.
The women are strongly present to affirm that they will continue to participate in the Great March of Return. The participation of the women in the 5 sites of the protest gives strength to the entire Palestinian society. Today, we have come to say that this land is ours and we have the right to return to our lands and we have the right to break the oppressive siege. We have come today in a peaceful demonstration to affirm that the choice of the Palestinian people is to defend their rights and to defend the homeland.
The Great March of Return called for the right to return of the descendants of nearly 750,000 people who were expelled from their homes in 1948 in what is known as the Nakba, or the catastrophe, during the formation of Israel. The protests also condemned the decision of US President Donald Trump to shift the US embassy in Israel to the city of Jerusalem, and the blockade of Gaza by Israel, aided by Egypt. From March 30, 2018, tens of thousands of people marched every week to the Gaza-Israel border in one of the largest acts of resistance in human history. Israel's response was brutal. Snipers, positioned on the Israeli side of the border, targeted the protesters, including women, children, medics and journalists. Tanks and artillery installations also fired at the protesters. Over the course of a year, 266 Gazans were killed, including 50 children and 6 women. Nearly 30,400 were injured, of whom 7,000 were wounded by live bullets. One of the worst incidents of violence was on May 14th, which marked the anniversary of the Nakba. It was also the day when the US embassy was shifted to Jerusalem. Around 60 people were massacred and more than 1,100 injured in one day alone. A recent report by the United Nations Independent Commission of Inquiry found that Israel's response to the Great March of Return could amount to war crimes or crimes against humanity. The report said that Israeli snipers intentionally targeted and killed unarmed civilians. Among the more brutal manifestations of Israeli violence was the use of butterfly bullets, which expand on impact. As of May last year, 20 Palestinians had their legs amputated due to the use of these weapons. These bullets are banned under the Hague Declaration of 1899. Israeli snipers have also targeted journalists and medics, despite them wearing jackets which indicate their profession. 2 journalists have been killed and 347 injured over the course of a year. Similarly, 3 medical professionals have been killed and 665 injured during the Great March of Return protests. The Israeli forces have also targeted medical infrastructure. As many as 112 ambulances have been partially destroyed due to firing. Despite the cruelty, the Palestinians are defiant. In the face of brutal fire, the medics have unflinchingly done their duty, saving thousands of lives. We spoke to Abu Ashraf Ukal, a medic with the Ministry of Health, to know about the situation on the ground.
We are engaged in humanitarian work in the midst of the Great March of Return and in breaking the siege. There are many difficulties that we face in the field. We are the first to reach the injured. As humanitarian crew working in the field, we should be under the protection of a number of international laws. There are fears and difficulties that we face while working in the field. We might be directly targeted when we go to the injured. Many of the ambulances have been targeted directly by tear bombs, live bullets or missiles. A number of our own ambulances have been targeted. There is a violation of the rights of medical and relief workers in the field. We have to evacuate the wounded and take them to a safe place and treat them because it is impossible to deal with these cases in the field. The wounded have to be taken to an area which we are sure won't be targeted so that we can start the treatment. We have been targeted and we have suffered injuries. Our ambulances have been targeted by direct shelling. But this is our duty even if our lives are exposed to danger. At the end, the demonstrations are peaceful, demanding legitimate rights that are part of all the international forums. We are part of this people, so we may be exposed to injuries like the ordinary citizens. We are ready to endure injuries in order to save a life or reduce the pain of the wounded. زي ما بيتعرض المواطن العادي للإصابة برضو احنا كمان بنتعرض للإصابة ومستعدين ان نصاب في سبيل احياء نفس او تخفيف الم عن المصاب. The people of Gaza have refused to back down or surrender. From the tent city that came up near the border, symbolizing the traditions of the people, to poems and songs that have gone viral online, the resistance has been marked by hope too. Dancing and music are an inseparable part of the protests. A unique feature of the protests has been the participation of all sections of society, including women and children. The people of Gaza are determined to take the struggle into their own hands. They know that it is the force of their will alone that will vanquish the might of the Israeli oppressors. We have come today to participate in the first anniversary of the March of Return and to prove to the Zionist occupation that we will not be subdued and we will not lose hope till we achieve all of our demands, and only after that we will stop the demonstration. Yeah.